Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, my name is Erica with Memory Box Candle Co. and I make videos all about making and selling candles. In today's video, I just wanted to go over some things that I have been preparing for and really thinking about when it comes to actually getting my candles into local shops. I've been wanting to do this for so long, but for some reason, I just have so many other things going on. I've been wanting to do farmers markets, wholesale, and sometimes I feel like I want to do so many things at once and I end up doing nothing. So I really thought, because especially since it's summertime right now and farmers markets and local events, it's just 100 degrees every day here where I live in Southern California, and I just don't think it's the best thing for me right now, maybe for the fall time, but I really do want to really elevate my business and get it moving forward. So today's video is just going to be me going over some things that I am preparing for when it comes to wholesale, getting my candles into shops, how I'm gonna go about doing that, and I just wanted to share it with you guys. So although I've never actually gotten my candles into stores just yet, I thought it would be fun to document this process of how I'm gonna go about doing that to hopefully help some of you guys out who are looking to do the same thing. So first things first, when it comes to trying to sell your candles wholesale and get them into stores, is to know your cost of goods and know your wholesale pricing. So I have made many videos before in the past talking about cost of goods and just how important it is to know your cost of goods and have a good profit margin, specifically if you want to do wholesale. So wholesale is one of those things where you want to make sure that you are going to be having a good return in your profit. So for instance, if your cost of goods is $4, I would recommend the cost of goods times 4 for your retail price and cost of goods times 2 for your wholesale price. So 4 times 4 is 16, 4 times 2 is 8. So you would sell your candles to the shop at $8, and then they would sell it to the public at $16. That's just kind of the basic formula to follow. Of course, you can change it up if you'd like to, but that is definitely the formula that I like to follow when it comes to offering wholesale pricing. So make sure that you have your cost of goods down. Make sure that you go over your finances, go over your numbers, go over everything, and make sure that you are going to benefit from wholesale. Even if you aren't going to get that full 50%, maybe you're only going to get 30 to 40%, ask yourself if you think that it's going to be worth it. In my opinion, 30 to 40% is still a pretty good return of your profit, and that is just something to consider on whether or not it's going to be worth it to you. So make sure you sit down, figure out your cost of goods, figure out how much you are charging retail, how much it costs you to make your candle, and then how much you will sell it to your local shops. The next part of wholesaling that I'm preparing for is to figure out what stores I actually want to reach out to try to get my candles into. So the type of shops that I've been thinking about are coffee shops, not like a Starbucks, but just kind of like a locally owned, smaller business kind of coffee shop. Hair salons, which I'm actually already working on with the girl who does my hair. I think she's actually going to be my first wholesale client, and I'm really excited about that. So coffee shops, hair salons, you could also look at local boutiques. I think that boutiques are probably one of the most popular places to look at because most of the time they're independently owned, and candles and clothing kind of go hand in hand. You could also look into if you have any kind of gift shops or specialty handcrafted stores. I have a lot of little kind of old town kind of shopping areas in my local cities that I live in, and a lot of them do carry a lot of handmade items. And you could also look into any independently owned smaller kind of grocery stores as well. You could go on the larger scale and get it into major stores, but for me, just starting out, I'm definitely just looking on the smaller scale. And after watching Jeff's video on wholesaling, he has a bunch of videos on wholesaling, so I will probably link those below for you guys to check out, because he has a lot more experience at than I do. I'd never even done it. This is just kind of me getting into it. But he was talking about how if you're in more of the major stores, you have to get barcodes and do that whole thing. So I'll leave his video linked below. But that is what I am preparing for, just looking through, going on Instagram, going just on my maps and just kind of looking through to little local shops that I would want to get my candles into. The next thing that I'm trying to figure out is how many scents I want to offer to them, because I have 16 plus scents and I think that's just going to be too much. I think it's going to be too overwhelming. So I'm trying to dial it down and maybe only offer 10 of those scents. Maybe take that down a little bit more. I'm trying to still offer a variety in the scent categories. Just like I've talked about before in my other videos, I want to make sure that when they are choosing the scents, they're not choosing all sweet scents or all floral scents or whatever it is. I really want them to have a diverse option for their shop, because everybody's going to have different scent preferences. So I'm just trying to determine. I think I'm going to offer them maybe 8 to 10 different scents to choose from. So I'm trying to create a list, which I pretty much have created the list of all of the scents that I have. I have the names, and then I also have the description of what it is, because my names are a little bit more unique with my candle names. Something else I wanted to throw in there is that I do want to offer customization for my wholesale. So I want to offer the option for them to customize the label. I do love customization, and I would charge a little bit more per label on the items, and that would just kind of increase my revenue, but also kind of give them more of a customizable touch to their business. So if they wanted to put their brand name on it, if they wanted to change the name on the label, for instance, if they didn't want Saturday morning cartoons and they thought that Fruity Pebbles would sell better, we could do that, you know, that kind of thing. So just being able to add in a little bit more of a customization so they feel like it's a little bit more personal to them and their shop. The next thing that I'm working on, and I've actually been working on this for a couple of months now, and that is a way to actually present my business to these local shops. Now, I don't know if this is going above and beyond, if it's too extra, if it's too much, but I really, really enjoy doing it. I enjoy design and I've enjoyed the creative process so far, but I really want to create a wholesale brochure that I can drop off at local businesses, along with a little sample of maybe one of my 6 ounce tin candles and a wax melt or whatever it is. I was thinking those would probably be the samples that I would want to drop off. But that is what I am thinking about doing. So I have created a little brochure, and it is a trifold, and I want to just get it printed through Vistaprint so it's a lot more professional. I'm just really trying to look as professional as possible so that people are like, yes, I want your candles in my shop, and try to just, you know, make it look like irresistible, essentially, is what I'm trying to do. So I really want to create this brochure and make it have all the information that they would need, contact information. I have my new business cards that I would also leave there as well, and just kind of feel a little bit more confident walking in instead of not having anything and just being like, hey, you know, do you guys sell candles, or can I get my candles in here? Which I'm sure works. I just feel like I'm just gonna go a little bit extra with it, and that's just kind of what I'm deciding to do. But I feel like it's a good idea. Even if you didn't get a professional brochure made, if you just had a sheet of paper that you printed out on nice paper, so, you know, like the resume paper, or just something that's nicer than just a flimsy piece of paper, and you just had your information on there, that they would know more about you and your brand. I feel like that is better than not having anything, especially ways of contact. And especially if it's just a salesperson and they're going to relay that information to the manager, I feel like it's just a little bit nicer to have it all put together than just kind of a business card and a word of mouth of like, oh, hey, this person came by, they want to get their candles in here. And it's just a business card. So that's kind of how I am thinking about it. I really want to have a really good first impression information. So that's the way that I want to go about it. So I wanted to let you guys know that that's what I'm going to be doing, just in case you want to do something similar to feel a little bit more confident when you are going into these places, because I know I am going to be super scared. I might film it just like I did way back when in a video where I was going in to try to sell my wax melts to local businesses, not to try to get them in the shop, just to sell to the front desk, which I gotta be honest, oh my gosh, I was so nervous. And then I just started handing off business cards because I got too nervous to ask them if they wanted to buy anything. I'm like, here's a free sample and here's my business card. And that was about it. But I really hope that I film that just to give you guys some feedback on what I'm feeling and what the response is. I feel like that might help you guys out. And then from there, hopefully people contact me wanting to get into my shop, and then we can go through a whole wholesale contract. I have some ideas on what I would want to put on a wholesale contract, but again, Jeff has a video on it and that gave me a lot of good ideas. And then maybe later on in the future, I could create templates for you guys if you wanted something for wholesale contracts or wholesale brochures or wholesale price sheets or whatever it is. I just love designing, so that's kind of something else that I could work on, and I've had a lot of fun with mine too. But I hope this video was helpful for you guys. I know that technically, you know, I don't have any experience with this, but I feel like I've done so much research and I'm a lot more prepared than I was a couple years ago when I first started thinking about, oh, wholesale would be really fun to do. I have a little bit more confidence in my brand and confidence in the knowledge that I have to be able to walk in and hopefully get a new wholesale client, because that is definitely something that I want to really focus on, because I feel like that is going to be the best way for me to grow my brand, especially locally, but also in a way that is going to help me scale my business. I know I've mentioned this before in the past, but I believe that wholesale is going to be the best way to scale my business and help me out when it comes to actually not just packaging, spending so much time packaging and shipping orders. It just takes so much time versus you can make all these orders. You have a set list of all of these candles you need to make. It needs to be made by this date. You can just go drop it off. You don't have to individually wrap it up. You can just drop it off at the shop, and then you can take really cute photos of your candles in a local shop. And I'm so excited for that. I'm super excited for that. But I really hope this video helped you guys out. If it did, make sure to leave it a thumbs up, as well as subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. And don't forget to follow me over on Instagram @MemoryBoxCandleCo. And I will see you guys in the next video. Bye, guys.